Hello everybody, welcome back to Jersh Reacts. In today's video, we are concluding our full album reaction to Lady Gaga's Chromatica. We have another track here, Love Me Right, which was a department store exclusive, which was separate from the bass studio album track listing. It looks like there's some alternate versions of A Thousand Doves and Stupid Love, which I may check out in the future, but I'm not going to check out right now as a part of this album reaction, since this is a, you know, another original song and not just an alternate version of a song I've already heard. We're going to say that this does conclude the full album reaction for me. If you like what you see on my channel, if you've enjoyed this series, if you like any other reactions that I do, or maybe you've seen the majority of what you want to see and you just really appreciated it, consider liking, commenting, and subscribing, or checking out my Patreon and my Twitch Prime to support me if you enjoy what I do. It makes a big difference and it means a lot. So I've got the lyrics pulled up and I've got the song pulled up. Now that, in my opinion, the Kindness Punk's journey has ended, I'll be curious to see what I get from an individual song perspective and a concept perspective for Love Me Right. Here we go.
Story, do you wanna know the truth? I'm tall in high heels, but I am only 5'2". What you see ain't always what you're gonna get. It's true. You see the best in me, even when I have no clue.
I like this track.
Take my picture for me and imagine what I do. I know what's best for me. Try to do what's best for you. This could all be fiction. I know that it sounds taboo.
Dude, the way that she's hitting that high note when she's singing with that melody is really impressive. It's really cool. I like the sound of this. This is a more... maybe the reason that it was separate was because, yes, there's sales involved and marketing involved and how do we get people to purchase the album in different ways and not just stream it and XYZ, whatever. There is that, but creatively, maybe this was decided to be a separate track because it is a different flow. Like, it doesn't have... I feel like the rest of the album had a pretty consistent sound and a pretty consistent tempo, like on the drums and the percussion, kind of a pulsating throughout the entire album, whereas this is kind of a more standalone, slower feel music wise and it's a little bit softer melodically, so maybe it didn't fit in with the theme of the entire concept album of Chromatica. Maybe that's why it's standing on its own as a separate track. So let's take a look at some of these lyrics. My life is a story, do you want to know the truth? I'm tall in high heels, but I'm only 5'2". What you see, you probably can hear the thunder because it's still storming as I talk about music for your entertainment. But I'm only 5'2". What you see ain't always what you're gonna get. It's true, you see the best in me even when I have no clue. I don't wanna feel this way no more, don't wanna feel this weight. Sick of hiding from myself, don't wanna feel this pain. Don't wanna run far from home, lose my way. I don't wanna be my friend no more, I wanna play this game. Would you still love me if I gave it all up just to cry? Would you still love me if I didn't tell you goodbye? Would you still love me right? Take my picture from me and imagine what I do. I know what's best for me, trying to do what's best for you. This could all be fiction. I know that it sounds taboo. I wear my heart on my sleeve. It's making its debut. So I think that, yeah, this is kind of like, this is almost like an epilogue where, you know, the dust has settled. We've been living normal life for a while. And now we catch eyes with somebody that we see another potential in, having learned the lessons, you know, mixed with the wrong crowd, the wrong people. So on an individual basis, it could be her saying like, hey, you know, this is me. These have been my ups and downs. Sometimes I wear my heart on my sleeve. Sometimes I hold back and conceal a little bit because I'm afraid of getting hurt. But this is what I'm all about. And hopefully that's all right. You know, I don't want to feel this way anymore. I don't want to feel this weight, whatever, you know, whatever it is, I want to feel good and be with somebody good. That's kind of what I'm getting from the individual. Would you still love me right? And I guess love me right means in the way that I deserve, in the way that I've earned because of the bullshit I've been through, right? Thematically, for the rest of the album, I can kind of see this as an epilogue too, where she's been living her normal life, she's assimilated, and now she's kind of ready to let the kindness punk go and just be another citizen on this planet. The love isn't spread, the kindness isn't spread, the battle's been won. We had, you know, our weekend of celebrating, and we've had our mundane and enjoyable life for a while now. Now I'm ready to meet somebody new. So now I want to tell them, you know, this tale of how I had my ups and downs, the things that I learned, where I came from, and if I can just be accepted as me, even though I'm from somewhere else, you know. So it's almost like the entity from another galaxy has now, they're here, they're home, they're comfortable, and they're trying to start to build this new life on this new planet. I doubt anybody else on the internet has said anything like that about this song. Just throwing that out there. Also, on the same theme of the, you know, concept album, whatever, she doesn't want the weight, the responsibility of spreading the love anymore. She just wants to live her own life. She just wants to be okay. But she doesn't, you know, I don't want to run far from home. She doesn't want to forget who she is or where she came from, but she wants to be allowed to be her own person and live her life for herself instead of for spreading the love that she's had to do her whole life. I don't want to be my friend no more. Whitney Houston vibes a little bit, and the music and the sudden high note. We're getting a proper fade out here. This feels like the album end. This is like the epilogue, the peek into what the next chapter could be. Screw it. I need you to listen to me. Please believe me. I'm completely lonely. Please don't judge me when your tears are falling. I'll catch them as they fall. I need you to listen to me. Please don't leave me. I'm not perfect yet, but I'll keep trying when your tears are falling. One sec. Okay. If we're going to hear a song we've already heard, and she's going to play it stripped down on piano so I can actually hear the music easier than without all the extra additive effects that a lot of her music has, then we're going to at least play along with it, right? Perfect yet, but I'll keep trying when your tears are falling. I'll catch them as they fall. 'Cause in sighing, we already mean the same. Thank you. depending on how that mixes, this is it. And then I was having fun with it, doing something. Okay, so yeah, that is going to do it. For the full album reaction, I'm glad I went ahead and did the 1,000 Doves piano version. It was fun to hear a clean version of that, to appreciate her playing and singing at the same time. I'm a musician and I can play the guitar, but I can do a little bit of piano, but I can't do piano with the full chord stuff. Maybe I'll make a series of teaching myself piano. I don't know. But I just love when musicians and singers can play piano and sing at the same time. It always impresses me, even what I consider the easy stuff on guitar. This was really fun to do. I can't say that I would choose to listen to an entire album start to finish every day, because I try to bring something different to the table to you all. I didn't just want to sit there and listen to the music. I wanted to give you, if you're a fan of my channel or you enjoy my reactions, I wanted to give you what you expected, which was thoughtful analysis and some interpretation and meaning from my own life and what I get from these songs. If you're new to the channel or you found me through the Chromatica reactions, hopefully you can see that I try to do things a little bit differently, that I don't just want to listen to the song. I want to see what the song means to me and share a little bit of my teeny tiny bit of musical knowledge as well. So this was a ton of fun. I appreciate you all supporting the channel, watching the channel. If you enjoyed this video series, can't stress enough, like, comment, and subscribe. Check out my Patreon and my Twitch Prime. The support, you know, the channel cannot continue in the future long term without support from people out there. So really appreciate you if you liked this video series or any other videos that you watch on my channel. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.